Morning students, here I am Ria, your chemistry teacher. As we done about the chemical and physical properties, reactions of acid and bases, their types, different types of acid and bases in the last two videos. Now the next video is the types of salts and their preparation and uses. In last slide we finished with our pH scale universal indicator concept, which is again important concept. Now the types of salts and their preparation and uses, which is one last topic of this chapter. So here we are dealing. So these are the different types of colors of salt. First I want to show you different colors of the salts. These are the form of salts, that is hydrated crystals, cobalt nitrates, calcium nitrate, nickel sulfate. So these are the salts present in our labs in this kind. Next is uses of the salts. These are the common salts. So here ammonium chloride, ammonium nitrate, calcium iodide, some of them may be asked in your exam, so you have to learn these uses. Iron sulfate, magnesium sulfate, potassium nitrate, in torch, batteries, fertilizers, as a drying agents, iron tablets, medicines, gunpowder, photography, making NaOH and making soap. So these are your common uses of the different salts. Now, what is salt? Salt having the same positive or negative radicals, that means a salt consists of a positive ion and a negative, positive cation and negative ion. Did I explain you in metals and non-metals? Not in this chapter. Radicals are called to develop or to belong to the family. For example, NaCl, Na2SO4. So NaCl consists of the Na plus and Cl minus. Na2SO4 consists of Na plus SO4. 2 minus belongs to the family of the sodium salts. So here we are dealing with the same metal sodium. So here are the sodium salts. Similarly, NaCl and KCl belongs to the family of chloride salts. So here the common ion is chloride Cl. So here both are belongs to the chloride salts. pH of salt. Salts of strong acid and a strong base having the neutral pH value 7. On the other hand, salts of a strong acid and weak base are acidic with the pH level less than 7. And those of strong base and weak acids are basic in nature with the pH value more than 7. Here the chemicals from the common salt. Now we are dealing with the common salt and number wise. The salt formed by the combination of hydrochloric acid and sodium hydroxide solution is called the sodium chloride. The first is your common salt having different names of the common salt, that is sodium chloride, rock salt and table salt. So sodium chloride form only by the neutralization reaction that we have done in the chemical properties of the acid and base. So hydrochloric acid is your HCl when react with the sodium hydroxide, that is your NaOH, gives you sodium chloride, that is NaCl plus H2O. So this is the salt that we use in food. It is a neutral salt. Sea water contains many salts dissolved in it. Sodium chloride is separated from the salts. Deposit of solid salt are also found in the several parts of the world, and these large crystals are often brown due to impurities. So the common salt is present in the form of stones having the impurities, which is brown in color. So this is called the rock salt, jisko hum sendha namak bhi bolte hain. Beds of rock salt were formed when sea of the bygone ages dried up and the rock salt is mined like a coal. So this is one of the historical aspect. Salts formed by the blend of hydrochloric acid and sodium hydroxide solution is called sodium chloride. So sprinkling of common salt, which is your sodium chloride, on the salad. The salt we commonly consume, it is neutral, and this neutral common salt act as a preliminary raw material for the extracting several other materials of daily use like sodium hydroxide, baking soda, washing soda and bleaching powder, etc. Next is very important concept for the exam point of view. Sodium hydroxide, which is your caustic soda, NaOH, passing electricity through the brine. Brine solution, here we are dealing with the aqueous solution of the sodium chloride. Aqueous NaOH is known to be the brine. So it is 1 mark question in the CBSC, what is brine solution? So the answer is aqueous NaOH solution of the sodium chloride is known to be the brine solution. It decomposes to give the chlorine and sodium hydroxide. 2NaCl plus 2H2O gives you 2NaOH plus Cl2 plus H2O, and this process is known to be the chloralkali process. So here is the question arises: what is chloralkali process? What is brine solution? Give the equation for the chloralkali process and explain what is present at the cathode and anode. So this is a 5-mark question coming from this area. The process is termed as the chloralkali process, and the term chlor for the chlorine, alkali for the sodium hydroxide. Chlorine gas is given off at the anode. Hydrogen gas is given off at the cathode. So anode and cathode are the two terminals of electrodes when it is connected to the battery. Anode generated and cathode generated when the electrodes present in the beaker connected to the battery, and the electrode which is connected to the positive terminal of the battery is known to be the cathode, and the electrode which is connected to the positive terminal of the battery is known to be the anode, and the electrode which is connected to the negative terminal of the battery is known to be the cathode. So sodium hydroxide solution is formed near the cathode, and the reaction takes place is as follow. So this is the reaction. Here you can see this is the picture from your NCRT. Here three cylinders, one beaker and two cylinder. H2 gas is there in red in color, which is at the cathode. Cl2 gas at the anode. Fuel, these are the uses of the H2 gas: ammonia for the fertilization, for the formation of fuels, ammonia for the fertilization, chlorine for the water treatment, swimming pool, PVC, disinfectant, CFC, pesticides, NaOH, degreasing metal, soap and detergent, paper making, artificial. So these are the products which formed when you are reacting with the brine solution of aqueous NaCl with water. So we get these compounds, and this process is known to be the chloralkali process. When we mix H2 plus CO2 combinedly, use the hydrochloric acid, cleaning steel, ammonium chloride, and when Cl2 is react with NaOH, it becomes bleach, which is used as a bleaching fibers. So there is a diagram which is newly added in the new books of the 10th class. Here is a beaker. Beaker consists of the aqueous NaCl, which is a brine solution. There is a two electrodes, chlorine gas electrode and hydrogen gas electrode. It's not a hydrogen or chlorine gas. It's just an electrode which is connected to the battery, and it becomes positive and negative anode and cathode. So when you are adding the sodium hydroxide near the cathode, so the chlorine gas stick at the anode and the hydrogen gas evolve at the cathode. So there is a chlorine gas anode and hydrogen gas cathode. So in this way the reaction is feasible and the chloralkali process taken place. Next is, so we have done the two salts, that is common salt NaCl and the caustic soda, that is NaOH. Now we are dealing with the third category of salt, that is bleaching powder. So you have already come to know that chlorine is produced during the electrolysis of the aqueous sodium chloride brine. So here the master is NaCl, sodium salt. So always we use the sodium salt to make the further salt. So this chlorine gas is used for the manufacture of the bleaching powder. So initially we get what? HCl plus NaOH, we get NaCl. That NaCl in the aqueous medium used to produce NaOH again in caustic soda. Here we using Cl2, which we can get from the last salt, that is chloralkali process. That Cl2 is used for making the bleaching powder here. So here we are taking the calcium hydroxide CaOH2 plus Cl2, it gives you CaOCl2 plus H2. That means we are getting the bleaching powder from the calcium hydroxide. So bleaching powder is produced by the action of chlorine on the dry slag line, that is calcium hydroxide, and bleaching powder is represented as calcium oxychloride through the actual composition is quite complex. So CaOH2 plus Cl2 give you CaOCl2 plus H2O. The uses of bleaching powder is for bleaching clothes and linen in the textile industry, for bleaching wood pulp in the paper factories, and for bleaching washed clothes in the laundry. As the oxidizing agent in many chemical industries, and for disinfecting drinking water to make it free for germs. Next category is baking soda, which we are using in our home also. The soda commonly used in the kitchen for making tasty crispy pakoras in baking soda. Sometimes it is added for the faster cooking, and the chemical name of the compound is sodium hydrogen carbonate, which is NaHCO3. It is produced using sodium chloride as one of the raw material. So it is one of the raw material. NaCl plus H2O plus CO2 plus NH3, ammonia plus carbon dioxide plus water plus NaCl, we are adding to get NH4Cl, which is ammonium chloride, plus NaHCO3, which is sodium hydrogen carbonate. It is a mild non-corrosive base, and the following reaction takes place when it is heated during cooking. So 2NaHCO3, which is your sodium hydrogen carbonate, when get heated, it becomes Na2CO3 plus H2O plus CO2. So these are the reaction, these are the two reactions to form the formation of baking soda. So uses of sodium hydrogen carbonate for making the baking powder, which is the mixture of baking soda, sodium hydrogen carbonate, and the mild edible acid such as the tartaric acid, when baking powder is heated or mixed in water, the following reaction takes place. Here the H plus of the tartaric acid is taken, not the whole formula is written here. So when H plus is added to this, CO2 plus H2O plus sodium salt of acid takes place. So here carbon dioxide produced during this reaction caused bread or cake to rise, making them soft and spongy. Sodium hydrogen carbonate is also an ingredient in antacids. Being alkaline, it neutralizes excess acid in the stomach and provide relief. It is used also in fire extinguisher. Next is washing soda. There is a spelling error here. Washing is W-A-S-H-I-N-G, washing soda. Another chemical that can be obtained from sodium chloride is Na2CO3.10H2O. It is also known as water of crystallization, washing soda. You have seen above that sodium carbonate can be obtained by heating baking soda. Recrystallization of sodium carbonate gives washing soda, and it is also called basic salt. So Na2CO3 plus 10H2O, 10 molecules of water, we combine get Na2CO3.10H2O. Here are the uses. Sodium carbonate washing soda is used in glass, soap, paper industries. It is used in manufacture of sodium compounds such as borax. Sodium carbonate can be used as a cleaning agent for domestic purposes. It is used for removing permanent hardness of water also. Now this is again next topic. These are the salts. One salt is left, that is plaster of Paris, POP. Are the crystal of salt really dry? Copper sulfate crystals, which seems to be dry, contain water of crystallization. When we heat the crystal, this water is removed and the salt turns white in nature. So this is the crystal, if we heat, then become white salt. If you moisten the crystal again with water, you will find that blue color of the crystals reappear. Water of crystallization is the fixed number of water molecules present in one formula unit of salt. For example, agar hum CuSO4 dekhe to CuSO4.5H2 hota hai, Na2CO3.10H2 hota hai. Jab hum isko dry heat kar dete hain to inke crystal water of crystallization yani 5H2O alag ho jayenge, aise hi 10H2O molecule alag ho jayenge. So on the other hand, water of crystallization in gypsum, so gypsum having the formula of CaSO4.2H2O. So here is the next salt, plaster of Paris. Again, very important concept from the exam point of view. On heating gypsum at 373 Kelvin, this temperature is very, very important. You have to write it. 373 Kelvin, it lost water molecules and become calcium sulfate hemihydrate. Hemi means half. This is called plaster of Paris. The substance which doctor use as a plaster for supporting fractured bone in the right position. Plaster of Paris is a white powder, and on mixing with water, it changes to gypsum, once again giving a hard solid mass. CaSO4.5H2O, that is your plaster of Paris, plus 1.5H2O gives you CaSO4.2H2O gypsum. If you write gypsum on the left hand side, then you have to heat it up and we get the reverse reaction, but heating is at 373 Kelvin. It is written in the form because two formula unit of CaSO4 share one molecule of water. Plaster of Paris is used for making toys, materials for decoration, and for making the surface smoother. Thank you.